Okay, so tickets for Spider-Man No Way Home are now on sale, and with the movie releasing worldwide in over just 2 weeks, we have a ton of new info on the film that has just hit the web. It's Spider Monday, and in this video we're going to be breaking down all the new trailers, TV spots, its runtime, leaked post-credit scene, and basically everything you guys want to know about the movie. There will be some spoilers here, but I'll save things like the leaked post-credit scene until the end of the video, so you have time to dive out in case you don't want to know. However, I won't be able to do a Doctor Strange spell on you for anything past this point, so you have been warned. With out of the way, let's Scooby-Doo this crap and get into our Spider-Man No Way Home breakdown. Okay, so with tickets now on sale, we actually know a lot more about the movie, including its official runtime. According to the Cineworld website, the film will be 148 minutes, which is 2 hours and 28 minutes long. This makes it the fourth longest MCU movie, and it's going to have a lot of things going on in its almost 2.5 hour runtime. We already know that the film will pick up immediately after the events of Far From Home, and it'll deal with Peter's identity being out there. He'll then go to Doctor Strange, trying to erase everyone's memory of himself, and probably Shane Dawson whilst you're at it, and he'll then try and interrupt the spell, which will break open the multiverse. From this will spring forward numerous villains from the Spider-Man Sonyverse, including Green Goblin, Dr. Octopus, Sandman, Electro, and the Lizard. Peter will then have to capture them whilst getting a little help from his friends, which will lead to one of the biggest Marvel movies of all time. Even though the world is dealing with new variants that sound like Transformer villains, I genuinely think that No Way Home will pass the billion mark, and it's going to be super interesting to see what pre-sale tickets are like. The movie opens on the 17th of December in the US and the 15th in the UK, so you American kids better start being nice in the comments, otherwise I will find you and I will spoil you. Now Sony have been ramping up promotion for the movie too, and we've had a lot of TV spots recently which have already done big breakdowns on. However, there's been some that released after I dropped that last video. This includes the IMAX promotional one, which for some reason was only released in phone format because A, it's Sony. Now the spot opens with Peter and MJ swinging through New York after his identity has just been exposed in the Daily Bugle report by J. Jonah Jameson. This scene is very reminiscent of the ending of Far From Home, in which he and MJ both swung through the city, and we know from the trailer that his face and name will be plastered almost across every screen in New York. We then got a much better shot of the Statue of Liberty holding up the Captain America shield replica, which is where the final battle will apparently take place at. I absolutely love the idea behind this, and though the concept of this being a big setting was leaked around the time of Falcon and the Winter Soldier, seeing it in all its glory is absolutely incredible. Now you might have noticed that there seems to be a figure standing on the scaffolding at the bottom. You can say computer, zoom and enhance all you want, but unfortunately the quality is pretty crappy and it's difficult to make out exactly who this is. However, if you cast your mind back to some of the apparent early leaks of Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield, then you'll remember that they were stood on similar scaffolding to this, and many have theorized that this smudge on the lens is our first look at the guy who's always late on his rent. I'm not too sure in all honesty, as I don't know if Sony would have wanted this to be the first time that we ever saw Tobey Maguire in the movie, but Sony being Sony, it would be pretty funny if we go to watch the film and see that's the case. Now according to leaks and reports, Toby and Andrew will come into the MCU at the same time, and they'll then come together and use their scientific knowledge to see what's going on and also how they should get out of the situation. Peter is of course a scientific genius, and I absolutely love the idea that they'll try and figure out what's going on first before teaming up with Tom Holland. We also got a look at Electro in his engineer's jacket, which was also leaked earlier in the year. According to some of the spoilers, Electro will warp into the MCU at a power station, which sort of ties into the location that he died at during the end of Amazing Spider-Man 2. From what I've been told, this will be very reminiscent of how the Terminator time travels, and from this point he'll then steal an electrical engineer's jacket before getting his harness and arc reactor later on. He'll also be wearing Tim's, which is quite funny, and I can't wait to see Tom Holland get his head stomped in by him. Now Electro has clearly just arrived into this universe as he's talking about all the possibilities, and I absolutely love this green and yellow jacket, which is of course a nod to the colours that he wore in the comics. Other moments include Doctor Strange throwing a train at Peter, and we can see this coming out of a portal behind him. This location looks like it's in Central Park, and we know from the trailers that the chase scene goes there, so I'm guessing that from this point onwards Strange can't catch him, so he just throws a train at him instead. Mysterio also did something similar on Far From Home, and poor Peter just can't seem to avoid getting a train run on him, eh? How about that? That one's for the dads, that one. Now, on my last video, we also talked about how Peter Parker's tie could be seen as being completely severed when he was talking to Strange in the Sanctum Sanctorum. This was because when Doc Ock attacked him and he was running low on nanotech, what remained moved from his head to his chest, and this cut the end of the tie off in the process. However, eagle-eyed viewers of you out there also correctly pointed out that at the start of Spider-Man 3, that Toby's tie gets cut in half too. Both him and Tom are also wearing extremely similar suits, shirts, and ties too, so this cutting of it could be a call back to that. Huge thank you to everyone who sent that Easter egg through, and thank you for letting me take credit for it. When I own my mansion, I'll be sure to give you a job cleaning the toilets, you sucker. Gotcha, you sucker. Now, the second TV spot that dropped online with the tickets is very funny, and it's titled Dude because it's pretty much what Peter and Ned say throughout the entire thing.
Tickets on sale now.
Dude! Cash!
Tickets on sale now.
Dude!
Tickets on sale now.
Dude! Dude!
Dude!
Exclusively in movie theaters.
Apparently tickets are on sale now.
Tickets on sale now.
Now, the spot opens with Peter hurtling through the mirror dimension with a cube in his hands that he stole from Strange's Sanctorum prison. This will apparently be used to trap the villains within the multiversal jail, and once it's powered up, it'll also allow him to send them back to their homeworlds where they'll die. Yay, now Peter grabs this and this begins the chase across the city. I think the scene is going to be crazy, and it'll be amazing to see Peter swinging through the mirror dimension whilst the whole of New York is collapsing around them. Next, we catch Peter FaceTiming Ned at the top of the Queensboro Bridge. This moment is clearly happening during the scene in which we see Peter and MJ standing on top of it, and we later catch her doing a balancing act trying to stay on the beam. I absolutely love this reaction to Peter's name getting out there, and this early part of the movie to me is pretty much going to be a metaphor for cancel culture. Guy is just completely freaking out he's been exposed, and it's absolutely hilarious. Now, I love how Ned's face can be seen on the phone at some points before it pops up on the screen almost like its own FaceTime call. The Queensboro Bridge is actually an important part of the Raimi-verse, as it's the place where Green Goblin and Spider-Man fought at the end of the 2002 movie. We can even catch one of the cable cars on it that Green Goblin held up, and MJ of course fell off it with Spider-Man catching her, which is somewhat mirrored in this scene. Speaking of bridges, we also got more of the bridge scene fight between Doc Ock and Spider-Man. Now, when Alfred Molina blabbed to the world that he was going to be in the movie, he said that it will open with him in the river that the character died in at the end of Spider-Man 2. We'll then see a portal appear in the Hudson River before we cut to black and catch back up with Tom Holland's Spider-Man. I've heard a lot of conflicting things over this and been told by some people that we just start immediately after the events of Far From Home. I tend to side more with that idea, as I don't know how much sense it makes from a narrative point of view to introduce the multiverse when the spell hasn't been done, to then jump back to the MCU to lead to the events of the spell, to then pull him across from the moment that we opened the movie with. That's just me thinking about how they would handle it, but anyway, that's the two things I've heard about the opening of the film. Now, this fight looks great, and there's edits out there that have pieced together enough of what we've seen to pretty much show us the entire scene. We've also had a brand new poster drop that's very much a variation on what's come before, but unlike the other ones we've seen for the film, Spider-Man is wearing his blue and red costume that was first seen in Civil War. This suit hasn't been shown in any clips of the film so far, and it'll be interesting to see how it's brought across. It's pretty much my favourite Spidey MCU costume, so I'm hoping he starts wearing this again for the final swing in the movie or something. Now, across the US, as soon as tickets went on sale, sites immediately went down faster than Ryan Airy's mom, and it even got to the point that people were listing them for $25,000 on eBay. When stuff like this happens, it's normally to build up some sensationalism on the internet, and though lots of people are like, "Oh my god, $25,000, you have to remember that you can choose your own price on eBay, and something is only actually worth what people are willing to pay for it. That being said, I bought 4,000 tickets from Bolden Cineworld this morning, and we'll be listing them at £50,000 a pop, and you'll pay for them, because you're a sucker, you sucker. Now, shoutouts CamShaft127 on Twitter for saying this is like the nerd equivalent of stocking up on toilet paper, and it definitely feels that way. Lots of panic buying, and it's going to be interesting to see if it beats Avengers Endgame's opening weekend box office of $1.2 billion. Kind of feels like nothing might ever top that again, but I think No Way Home will definitely be the first film post-pandemic to actually pass the billion mark. Should call it Spider-Man No Way, Are You Getting Tickets, hey? Having that? Now for the next part of the video, we're going to be talking about the leaked post-credit scene for the movie. I'm not sure how legitimate this is, but just in case it's real and you don't want the movie ruined by Steven Spoilsberg, then I highly recommend that you get. Go on now, get! Anyway, the post-credit scene will apparently pick up after the events of Venom Let There Be Carnage, with Eddie Brock being sat in his hotel room, still confused about what's going on. According to the leaks, he'll then be transported back to the MCU without ever even interacting with Spider-Man. However, we will see that some sort of symbiote will remain behind in the universe, and this will then make its way to Tom Holland's webhead. This is because it's seen him on the TV, and in future movies it could then attach itself to him, which will set up the events for the next Spider-Man trilogy involving the black suit. Now if this turns out to be true, then it's wild to me that the whole tease at the end of Let There Be Carnage will pretty much just have been done as a way to get a bit of the symbiote into the MCU. If they go through with this, then Feige clearly just wanted the symbiote and nothing else from those movies, so he's pulled off this big thing to get it. It's going to be a bit weird to me if all they've done is start a Venom franchise separate from the MCU, then have him go to the MCU, give Peter the symbiote to then have Peter go through the black suit arc, only to give it to Eddie Brock of the MCU so that we can have Venom. It is rumoured that the third Venom film will have him fighting against Spider-Man, so potentially we might get him going against Garfield or Maguire, but that remains to be seen. I kinda hope this isn't true, as it's gonna be pretty controversial if it is, as that post-credit scene might be a bit null and void, and they probably could have just introduced the symbiote some other way without getting our hopes up. That's a very first world problems response for me to have to it, but yeah, I would have just liked to have seen them all face off against one another, and then we could have set up the Lethal Protector storyline from the comics, in which Spider-Man and Venom were allies. Who knows what direction things will take. But I've asked about, and from what I've been told, this is what's gonna happen in the movie. However, bear in mind that the leaked post-credit scene for Far From Home said that we'd end with a tease on Oscorp Tower, so these rumours could just end up being fake, like them 700 Spider-Man trailers you see on YouTube every day with Toby and Andrew in them. Yes, I've seen them, yeah? Stop sending me them, they're fake! That's why I'm not doing breakdowns on them, they're fake, you idiot! Anyway, thanks for all the messages that you guys always send. And obviously, I'd love to hear your thoughts, so make sure you comment below and let me know. As a thank you, you'll be entered into a competition, and we're giving away 3 copies of Zack Snyder's DC Trilogy on the 30th of November. All you have to do to be on the chance of winning is like the video, make sure you subscribe with notifications on, and drop a comment below with your thoughts on the video. Not the part where I called you all idiots. Anyway, if you want something else to watch, then make sure you check out our breakdown of Venom Let There Be Carnage and all the Easter eggs in it. We found lots of cool callbacks to the comics, some hidden details, and it just had a lot of fun with the movie, so definitely go watch it right after this. If not, then thanks for sitting through the video. I've been Paul, I'll see you in the next one. Take care, peace.